Hi, this is Jules Barsky, and I am coming to you from Chester in the UK. Today is Monday the 25th of September 2017, and this marks the 6th anniversary of the very first Death Cafe, which took place in the home of our founder, John Underwood, in Hackney in London. It was facilitated by our mum, Susan Barsky-Reed. John was the waiter at the event, and I had a small contribution, having designed the menu for the 6 attendees. Since then, the Death Cafe guidelines have been posted online, and this has been picked up in over 51 countries. And to date, there have been over 5,000 Death Cafes. This means that in the last 12 months, we have had nearly 2,000 additional events in over 20 additional countries, which is incredible. But our fifth year has also been the most difficult for Death Cafe, because this year we lost our founder. On the 27th of June 2017, my brother, John Underwood, Death Cafe founder, died very suddenly of a brain hemorrhage, which was caused by a type of rare leukemia. These last 3 months have been indescribably difficult for our family. And I know that so many of you in the Death Cafe community were very deeply affected also by John's death, those of you who knew him, but also so many people who had never had the privilege of meeting him. John touched the lives of so many people. And today, on Death Cafe's birthday, I want to say a heartfelt thank you to the Death Cafe community and its supporters for everything that you gave my brother over the past 6 years, because without you, Death Cafe would never have happened. And I know that John was truly very thankful for everything that this community gave to him. There have been tens of thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, of people who have benefited from the work that John began, which is providing a safe space for people to discuss death and dying with like-minded individuals over tea and delicious cake, and having the opportunity to speak about death and dying, providing them with an opportunity to really make the most of their finite lives. Shortly after John died, a Just Giving page was set up by his friends at The Good Funeral Guide and Louise Winter, and we had over 400 people donate and raised over £40,000, which will go to John's wife Donna and his children Frank and Gina. And a massive thank you to anybody who donated to that. It will make such a huge practical difference to their lives. So, looking forward to the next 12 months, hopefully we'll see even more Death Cafes happening in more countries. And we also have some other things in the pipeline. We want to hold a memorial for John, where people from the Death Cafe community can attend. Realistically, we need the mental time and space to put something together that will truly reflect the impact that John had on this movement. So I'm very grateful for the patience that you have shown in waiting for this to happen. And we will, of course, let you know when it will be taking place. We're also going to be continuing to fundraise for Death Cafe to ensure that it enables its sustainability. So if you are interested in funding Death Cafe, please do let us know, and we will be announcing how we will be taking these donations in the next few months. So I guess I'm going to leave saying thank you again to everybody, and you know, I'm so grateful that you've all been here, and it's been a real comfort for us to have you all. I hope to meet many of you over the next 12 months via email or Google Hangouts. And if you would like to do anything to support Death Cafe, please do get in touch on our website. Just contact us, and we'll be checking these on a weekly basis. So thank you very much, and happy birthday.